NCTV 45, The Train, anytime on your time.
Our next speaker will be Michelle Shaw.
Try to put the drugs down and not change anything. right? It's some work on the inside. I had to put some work in. My God, our God, will move mountains, but he will give you a shovel. And that's what he did, you know. I went back to treatment in Rock Creek, Ohio. I came back here. I went to a three-quarter house, Sean's house. And that was starting the journey and saving my life. I did 10 months there. I started doing some things. I got involved in a 12-step program that taught me that my addictions are not exclusive to drugs. There are a lot of things that I'm addicted to, and a lot of things that will make my life unmanageable and not just using drugs. There were things that I had to work on, and I started doing that, you know. Sometimes people say things to you, right, and I don't think they understand the impact that they make when they say it, right? But my house manager at the time said to me, Michelle, sometimes you just got to look at things differently and things will get better. And I'm like, what? What does that even mean, right? But I started doing that, and I did. I started looking at things differently. My perception changed. I started looking at myself as a survivor from my past trauma and not a victim to it. Right? I started looking at, in the beginning, when my daughters only talked to me for 20 minutes, it was 20 minutes more than they talked to me yesterday. Right? Because we're so self-centered. In the moment, I'm like, I'm your mom, you're like, well, I am. Like, you gotta talk to me. Like, that's what you're supposed to do. No, it doesn't work like that. Like, I have some amends to make. I have some work to do. You know? And I started doing that, and things did get better. They did get better. I have a relationship with my daughters, all three of them are here. They live with me. I have a relationship with my mom today who can depend on me. When I say I'm going to do something, I do it. I'm a friend today. I'm a recovering person that shows up. When I say I'm going to be there, I'm there. I do the things that I say that I'm going to do. I'm a great grandmother to a grandson who has never seen me high. If I keep doing the same things that I'm doing now, it will remain that way. Somebody said to me tonight, Dameron, over there, right? Shout out to Dameron. She's like, as long as God's will is in my life, I won't use. Period. Right? That's what it is. If God's will is in my life, so I want to conclude by saying something. Like, I was thinking about this. You know, everybody knows, like, the famous picture, like, from the Bible where Jesus is knocking on the door. You know what picture I'm talking about? And you notice, and it says in the Bible, like, I'll stand at the door and knock. But if you look at the picture, there's no doorknob, no latch, anything on the side that Jesus is on, right? Because he can't just open the door. Like, we have to open the door. You have to let him in. Addiction is the same concept. It's the only prison where the locks are on the inside. It's the only prison where the locks are on the inside. So you have to open the door. You are your way out. You have to open the door. Ask God to come into your life. Ask him for some help. Ask the people in your life for some help. You know, if this is possible, if I can do this, anybody can do this, right? And I strive for today. I'm better than I was yesterday. Am I going to make mistakes? Yes. But tomorrow I'm going to try to be a better person than I am today. Unlock the prison door and come out.
Simple. Do what you say you're going to do. Michelle, I'm sorry, Stephanie's up next. I apologize. I'm one of my favorite people. Michelle, my dad used to tell me the definition of personal integrity is really simple. Do what you say you're going to do.
You're watching. You have your own.
Okay, we're giving away some.